Good morning children, I am Naveen sir, your math teacher of Kakatiya Public School. Yesterday topic we discussed about the different types to solve the simple equations. So these simple equations also help to solve the various problems, different types of problems in our daily life. For example, age type of problems, age problems, and money problems, some of the denominations. Like these problems, these simple equations are helpful in our daily life. So today we are going to discussing about the different types of problems. If we add 7 to twice a number, we get 49. Find the number. So what they are saying? If we add 7 to twice a number. So twice a number they are saying. So are they given any number? No, they did not given any number. So solution. Let the number B x say, number B x say. So taking as an unknown variable. Now what is saying after twice the number? So twice the number nothing but two times, double. So x plus x nothing but 2x. So how much we added? 7 added to which number? Twice of a number. So 7 is added to twice a number. 7 is added to twice a number. Then for 2x, how much we are adding? 7 is added. So if 7 is added to twice a number, what we are getting? We are getting 49. So by problem, for twice a number, if you are adding 7, you will get a 49. Then you should find the number. So now 7 is transposing to LHS to RHS, transposing to RHS. Then plus quantity is given as a minus quantity. Then 2x is equals to 49. So plus 7 will be minus 7. Then 2x is equals to 49 minus 7 is how much? 42. Now again 2 we have to transpose here. So 2 is transposing, 2 is transposing to RHS. 2 is transposing to RHS. Then here the 2 is multiplying with the variable x. Then LHS size is 2 is multiplying. So if you transpose, the multiplication quantity will be divided. Yes or not? Right. So x is equals to 42 by 2. So this side is LHS side is a multiplication quantity. It will move for RHS, it will become as a division quantity. So now gets cancellation. 2 1s are 2, 2s are 4, and 2 1s are 2. So x is equals to 21. Therefore, the required number is 21. So the required number is 21. So this is the problem. What the given? If we added 7 to twice a number, we get 49. Then find the number. So like this we have to do the twice. Then after we should add the 7. Then after by problem, if you added 7 to twice a number, then you will get 49. After simplification, the required number is what? 20. Now second problem, children. Sum of two numbers is 95. If one exceeds the other by 3, find the numbers. So how many numbers are given? Two numbers. The sum of two numbers is how much they are given? 95. So did they give any direct number? No. So solution, first they given two numbers, they are comparing two numbers. See, one exceeds the other by 3. So we don't know the one number, we don't know the other number. So first let the one number, the first number, nothing but one number be x same. So first number we have to x same. Then other number, other number, other number is what? X is nothing but subtraction. X is nothing but subtraction. So the other number exceeds by how much? 3. Subtract 3. So the one number is x, the other number is exceeds by 3. Nothing but x minus 3. Now sum of two numbers. Sum of two numbers is equal to how much they given? 95. Now we have to add these two numbers. Then x plus x minus 3 is equals to 95. So we have to add the variables. X plus x. X plus x is how much? 2x. Remaining minus 3 is equals to 95. Now minus 3 we have to transpose to RHS. So minus 3 is transposing to RHS. Then 2x is equals to 95 minus quantity is become as a plus quantity. Then minus 3 is become as a plus 3. Now 2x is equals to 95 plus 3 is how much? 98. Next, now we have to transpose 2. So LHS is 2 is multiplied with variable x. Then if you transpose to RHS, then the multiplication quantity is become as a division quantity. Then x is equals to, now here we should write 2 is transposing to RHS. Then x is equals to 98 by 2. 98 by 2. So 2 ones are 2, 4s are 8. Remaining 1, 2 9s are 18. Now x is equals to 49. Therefore one number we took as a x. Then x1 is how much? 49. So then first number is how much? 49. And now we have to find out the other number. Other number is how much? Other number is x minus 3. Then x minus 3, x is how much? 49 minus 3. So 49 minus 3 is how much? 46. So these two numbers are 49 and 46 are two numbers. So if you add this 49 and 46, again you get the 95. So look at here, 49, 46. 9 plus 6, 15. 1 carry, 4 plus 4, 8 plus 1, 9. Then sum of two numbers, again we got 99. Third problem. After 15 years, Hema's age will become 4 times. Then our present age, by comparing her present age, when after 15 years her age becomes 4 times, then find her present age. Find her present age. So we don't know the present age. the given after 15 years her age will become as a 4 times the given. Then we ask him to find her present age. So we don't know her present age. So what we have to do? Solution. Let her present age. Let Hemas. Hemas present age be x same. So her present age you should take as a x. Then after 15 years Emma age will become 4 times. Then after 15 years Hema's age becomes 4 times. 4 times. Then after nothing but plus, before or ago nothing but minus. Ago nothing but ago. 2 years ago, 2 years before means we have to go back side. We have to do subtraction. After nothing but we have to add. Upcoming years means we have to add. So Emma's after 15 years nothing but x plus 15. After 15 years of Emma's, how many times? 4 times of her present age. 4 times of her present age. So 4 times of her present age is how much? X. Then x plus 15 is equals to 4 into x, 4x. Now x is transposing to RHS. X is transposing to RHS. Then plus quantity is become as a minus. Then 15 is equals to 4x minus x. Then 15 is equals to 4x minus x is how much? 3x. Now 3 we have transposed RHS to LHS. Now here multiplication quantity is become as a division quantity. So 3 is transposing to LHS. 3 is transposing to LHS. Then 15 by 3 is equals to x. 15 by 3 is equals to x. Now let's translation. 3 ones are 3, 5s are. Therefore x is how much? 5. Nothing but x is what? Present age. So therefore Hema's present age is equals to 5 years. Then Hema's present age is how much? 5 years. So this is the problem. They given as a 15 years ago, 15 years after. 15 years after her age is will be 4 times of her present age. So after nothing but x plus 15 is equals to how many times? 4 times. After simplification, Hema's present age we got as a 5 years. Now this is fourth problem. A sum of 3000 rupees is to be given in the form of 63 prizes. So the total amount is 3000 rupees. He is distributed as a total prizes 63 prizes. If the prize money is either in the denominations of 100 rupees or 25 rupees, find the number of prizes of each type. So what they given here? Total amount they given 3000 rupees and total prizes also they given 63 prizes, and the prizes are in the denomination 100 rupees prizes are there and 25 rupees prizes are there. Then how many number of 100 rupees prizes are there and how many 25 rupees prizes are there, we have to find out. Each type we have to find out. So solution. So we don't know how many 100 rupees prizes are there, we don't know how many 25 rupees prizes are there. So first Let the number of 100 rupees prizes be x same. So 100 rupees prizes we are taking as a x. Then number of 25 rupees prizes. 25 rupees prizes. How many total prizes are there? 63. So if 100 rupees prizes are x we are taking, then from total 63 prizes, if we subtracted 100 rupees prizes, then you will get 25 rupees prizes or not? Yes. So we know total prizes and we don't know 25 rupees prizes and 100 rupees prizes. We don't know. First, we are taking as 100 rupees prizes as a x. Now, from the total prizes, we are subtracting 100 rupees prizes. Then we will get 25 rupees prizes. Okay?
Right.
Now we have to find out the value of prizes. Now we have to find out the value of prizes. Why? Because value of the prizes, total value, how much is given? 3000 rupees is given. So value of prizes is equals to 100 rupees prizes are x plus and 25 rupees prizes are 63 minus x. So value is how much total? 3000. Value is how much? Total value of prizes is how much? 3000. Then 100 into x, 100x plus 25 into 63 is how much? 1575. 1575 minus 25 into x. Now 3000 is equals to 100x minus 25x. How much? It will be 75x plus 1575. Now this 1575 we have transposed to RHS. Plus quantity is become as a minus quantity to LHS. Sorry, RHS to LHS we are transposing. Plus quantity is become as a minus quantity. So 1575 is transposing to LHS. Transposing to LHS. Then 3000 minus 1575 is equals to 75x. Now subtract from this, from 3000, 1575 if you subtract it, then you will get 1425 is equals to 75x. Again 75 we have transposed to LHS. Then 75 is transposing to LHS. Transposing to LHS. Then multiplication quantity is become as a division. Then 1425 by 75 is equals to x. Then now we can get the calculation that 15 table, 15 5s are 75. Now 15 9s are 135. 15 9s are 135. Then remaining is how much? From 140 to 135 gone. Then remaining how much? 7. So 75. Again 15 5s are 75. Now 95 by 5 is equals to x. Then 5 1s are 5. Again here 5 1s are 5. Remaining 4. 4 nothing but 45. 5 9s are 45. X is equals to 19. X is nothing but what? 100 rupees prizes. Therefore, number of 100 rupees prizes is equals to 19. So, a number of 100 rupees prizes is how much? 19. Now we have to find out the number of 25 rupees prizes. So therefore, number of 25 rupees prizes is equals to how much? 63 minus x. 63 minus x. Then 63 minus 19. It is a 44. So a number of 100 rupees prizes are 19. Number of 25 rupees prizes are 44. So this is the problem about the denominations, different types of denominations. Now listen children, worksheet that is homework problem. First one, total number of boys and girls in a class is 42. So the total strength of a class is 42. The boys and girls are total 42. Now if the number of girls is 10 more than the boys, so the girls are 10 members more than the boys, then find the number of boys. Now second one, if we subtract 22 from 3 times a number, we get 68. Then find the number. So how many times a number? 3 times a number. After 3 times a number, what we are doing? Subtracting 22 from 3 times of number, then you get 68. Then you have to find out the number. So third one, the present age of Raju's father is 3 times of Raju's age. So now the present age of Raju's father age is 3 times of Raju's age. After 5 years, sum of their ages would be 70 years. After their 5 years, after 5 years, sum of their ages would be 70 years. Find their present ages. So we should find the present ages. Thank you.